and welcome back to my channel. I'm Gianna. In today's video, you're going to be getting a tutorial on how to get this look right here. So without further ado, let's get into the video. All right, so to start this glam look, I'm going to start with my eyes and do my eyeshadow first because there's going to be a little bit of fallout and I don't want it to mess up foundation. So I always do foundation last so that way it doesn't get messed up. To prime my eyes, I'm going to use the NYX eyeshadow base in white, and I'm going to use just my finger. It's like a little pot. And I'm going to put a little bit on each eye. Now that I have my eyeshadow base on, I'm gonna go in with my first color, which is just gonna be my transition color. And it's gonna be Tempura from the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. So I'm gonna take a little bit of Tempura on a flat packing brush, and I'm just gonna apply it all over the lid, all the way up to my brow bone. And this is just gonna give me a good base, so when I start using my more bold colors, they blend out easier. Now we're gonna go and put Tempura on the other eye. And like I said, from the lid all the way up to the brow bone. Once you have your transition shade on both eyes, you're gonna take whatever blending brush you have. This one is from Morphe. It came with one of their Morphe brush sets. And I'm gonna dip into the color Railgar. Or Real Gar, not really quite sure on the Modern Renaissance palette. It's this kind of a burnt orange, darker orange color right here. So I'm going to dip into it and tap off a little bit of excess because of the fact that Anastasia Beverly Hills palettes are extremely pigmented, so you're probably gonna get a little bit of fallout from the shadow, which is okay. And now I'm just gonna blend this into my crease. When you first start blending, it's gonna look a little bit wild because, like I said, the colors are really pigmented, but it's okay. I want that deep orange color in the crease, so I really just wanna blend that out. I'm gonna continue to blend out Real Gar until I get it where I want it, where I think that it's nice and blended, but it still gives me that bright, burnt, dark orange color that I wanted. Now I'm gonna go into Real Gar again, same brush, and I'm gonna tap off the excess like I did before because, like I said, Anastasia Beverly Hills palettes are very pigmented. And now I'm gonna go in on the other eye and do the same as I did before and just really blend out that beautiful color all the way through my crease. Continuing to blend in my crease, but avoiding my lid because that will be for another color later. Once the Real Gar color, or the deep orange that we're using, blends out, we're gonna go into another color in the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. And we're gonna go into Red Ochre, which is right here. It's kind of a brick red, a little bit deeper, and it will complement the orange we already put in our crease. So we're gonna do a little bit of the Red Ochre, and we're gonna go into our crease, just like we did with Real Gar, and we're just gonna blend that out. Gonna take Red Ochre and blend it out on the other crease as well. So once you have Red Ochre blended out into your crease, then you're going to take the color Cypress Umber, which is right here. It's this dark brown shade. You're still gonna use the same brush because it's gonna help you better blend out the colors that you've been using, because there's still a little bit of product left on the brush. So I'm gonna take just a tiny bit of the Cypress Umber And I'm going to go in, but I'm going to keep it pretty tightly in my crease. I'm going to just try to keep it as close to the start of my crease as possible and not go all the way out with it like we did with red ochre and real gar. Once you have Cypress Ember blended into your crease, close to the start of your crease, you're gonna take that brush that you were using, whatever blending brush, you can see it's covered in product, of it's like brown, the orange, the red, all the colors we used. So I take just a dry, old washcloth, doesn't really matter, and I just kind of like spin my brush on it. And you can see that it's starting to take off some of that color that was on your brush, because I don't want any more crazy amount of product on my eye. So once you get off a lot of the color, see the brush is much better than it was, you're gonna go back into Tempura, that first color we used, and you're gonna just blend it right over the top of the shadows you were using, right up top near your brow bone. And this does it, kind of covers up those shadows so that it doesn't look like you have this crazy harsh line all the way up to your brow. And it just helps kind of blend them. And you're gonna go in and do once more little blend everything. So re-blend what you blended up top and re-blend it with the colors closer to the crease line. Now that I finished blending up my crease to what I would like, I'm gonna start working on my lid. So first on my lid, I'm going to take this e.l.f. Smudge Pop in Cruisin' Chic. And I'm going to apply just a little bit onto each lid. Because the smudge pot is more of a creamy texture, I'm going to take the lip brush by Ulta and I'm going to just dip into it. And I'm going to take it and I'm just going to apply it directly on my lid, not in my crease. Now that I have the smudge pot on my eyes, I'm going to take the color Telepathy by ColourPop. It's part of the Kathleen Lights Where's the Night collection, I believe, or Where's the Light collection, one of the two. But it's called Telepathy, and it's this beautiful gold. It's very pigmented and really just, look at that. It's gorgeous. So I'm just gonna take that same lip brush that we used to apply our smudge pot and just dip into it a little bit. And this is the same, has more of a creamy consistency. It's one of the Super Shock Shadows by ColourPop. And I'm gonna take it and just apply it a little bit to the center of my lid. And now that I have it kind of on the center, I'm just gonna use that same lip brush to kind of blend it in on the sides. But still leave that really golden pop in the center. See how that center just kind of pops a little bit more with that gold? I'm gonna take a little bit more of Telepathy and do it on the other side. I like this because it helps give just a little bit of a pop to the center of my eye, and it just looks good to me. So once you have your lid, you're gonna take that blending brush you were using earlier and just kind of blend out around your crease, right where your crease meets your lid. so that way you can just kind of meld the lid with the crease so that it's not so crazy or harsh, or just to clean up if you got into your crease a little bit with your lid color. Today I'm going to be using both an e.l.f. liquid liner and an e.l.f. gel liner. They're both in black, and I'm going to take the liquid liner first. This is the Intense Ink Eyeliner. This is the Intense Ink Eyeliner by e.l.f., and it is a pen. See, it's got a little felt tip, and I like to use this to just do my outline of my liner and then fill it in with gel. So I'm going to take the ink liner and I'm going to go close my eye. I like to do this looking down, which I have a mirror below me. That's why I'm looking down in this video. But I like to take it and just start the end of my eye and first do one line up, see, and then meet where that line ended, the first line we did, and do a line, another line down. Meeting the top. See, so it's got this kind of So see, we have this outline, but now we need to fill it in. So now that I have my outline, I'm gonna fill it in with my e.l.f. gel liner. So it's like a little pot like this. I'm gonna take an eyeliner brush, this one's from Morphe, and I'm going to dip into the gel liner, get product on the brush, and now I'm just gonna fill in that outline that we created with our liquid liner. So I did one eye, now I'm gonna go on and do the other. I'm gonna take my liquid liner again. I like to shake it. Maybe give it a little swipe on the hand so that you know the product's coming out. Now the reason I use two different liners when I do it, because I find that a lot of the liquid liners don't give me the color payoff I want. Like, they're not as black and they're not as dark or matte. And the gel gives me that matte black look that I want. But the liquid, especially these felt pens, are great for when you're figuring out how to do liner, how to fill in your area. It helps you do the wing. We have that liquid liner, put it into our gel liner pot. And fill in what we've already done with the liquid. Once you have your liners about even or where you would like them, you're going to go in with your false lashes. I'm going to be using these beautiful lashes. They're the Demi Wispies by Ardell. They sell them in the 1-pack, the 2-pack, and I think the 5-pack. They're one of my favorite lashes. Ardell is a super great brand if you're wanting to get into lashes. Ardell is great because they are an affordable brand. So if you're just trying to get into lashes and full glam makeup, it's great to start with Ardell. They also sell so many different types, whether it's natural or more glam. I use the Duo Glue. And you can use the end of a Q-tip, or I have this little tool that came with the lashes, and I'm just going to take the glue and just kind of go along and just create a little bit of a line. Let that one dry and do glue on the other lash. You're going to want your lash to dry for about 10 to 25 seconds till they're tacky. So once your lashes are almost completely dry on your eye, if you were a little messy, which I was just a teeny bit today, once your lashes are almost completely dry and the glue is almost dry, you can take a little bit of a matte black shadow, doesn't really matter, whatever you have, and then just dust it. On top of where you see little spots of lash glue. And that will help cover any mistakes you had. Once your lashes are completely dry, after you've already applied your black shadow to fix any mistakes, you can gently curl your lashes so that they kind of stick to your falsies. And then you can take your mascara, whatever mascara you like to use. I'm going to use this Tartist Lash Paint by Tarte. And just brush my real lashes in with my fake lashes. It'll help them look a little bit thicker, as well as just help blend them better with your natural lashes. And now I need to do my eyebrows. For my eyebrows today, I'll be using the NYX Eyebrow Pencil in black. And there's two sides. One has a spoolie, the other side has a pencil. So I'm going to take the spoolie and I'm going to brush out my brow hairs. So now I'm just going to be filling in the line, creating the shape of the brow that I want, or following along on the shape of my natural shape of my brow. Usually I want to clean up a little bit. I take a small little detail brush like this and I take a little bit of my concealer and I just kind of help with the shape. Once you clean up under your eyebrows, if you want to, you can always go in back in with that blending brush and just kind of blend out the shadows just up there. So it's not such harsh of a line from the concealer. Okay, now that our eyes are done, our brows are done, I got a little bit, as you can see, a little fallout from the black shadow, a little other fallout. I'm gonna take a makeup wipe, a clean makeup wipe, and just clean under my eyes from any of that fallout. So now we have these glam eyes done. Now we're gonna work on our face. I'm going to use this Josie Maran Surreal Skin Argan Finishing Balm. And I'm going to take with a clean finger and just kind of work it into my skin. Now that we have our primer on, so our base of our face, we're gonna take our foundation. Today I'm using the Urban Decay All Nighter Foundation. And I'm gonna use this little ceramic dish I have. It's like a regular one that you would use for sauces or something for the kitchen. But you can use really anything you can put on your hand. I just like having this because then I can clean it and it's easier. So I use 1.5 pumps of the foundation, so a little dot of that. And then I come in with a little foundation brush. This is the e.l.f. Professional Foundation Brush. And I dip into the foundation. And then I just create my little spots all over my face. Once you kind of have your foundation spread on your face, take your beauty blender or your Real Techniques sponge or whatever you prefer to use and blend out your foundation. Don't forget to take it down the neck. Or for me, a non-existent neck. Now that we have our foundation blended, we're gonna go and do our concealer. I'm gonna use the NARS Creamy Concealer in Vanilla today. And I'm going to apply it under my eyes. On my chin, a little on my Cupid's bow, and down the bridge of the nose. And blend that out. Now that the concealer is blended out, I'm going to take this Laura Mercier setting powder. It's the translucent setting powder, and it is literally my favorite. I'm gonna take my wet beauty blender, and I'm just gonna bake a little bit under the eye. Now I have my foundation and my concealer, and I'm going to start on my contour. Today for contour, I'm going to be using this Morphe 9C highlighting contour palette, and I'm going to just do a little bit of contouring, not a crazy amount, but just a teeny bit. So first I'm going to take one of this lighter shadows right here and just warm up my cheeks a bit. And I'm using this Morphe contour brush. The bristles are really soft, not super dense. So I'm not applying, so that way I'm not getting a crazy amount of product on at one time. I'm gonna go in with, this is the darkest shade in the palette. And do a little bit more strong contouring with this color. I'm going to use this Tarte High Performance Naturals little palette. It came with one of their holiday sets, and I'm going to dip into the blush and just dust the apples of my... Now for my highlight, I'm going to use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit, and I'm going to use the shade Taffy right here. So we use Taffy for our cheeks, for our cheek highlight, and then I'm going to use, from the same palette, I'm going to use the color Marshmallow for the highlight right above my brows, a little bit on my chin. I'm going to use Marshmallow for my nose. And then I'm going to take this little e.l.f. blending eye brush and take Marshmallow and use it in my inner corner. And just kind of blend that inner corner a little bit out so that it kind of finds its way almost into your eyeshadow. Alright guys, now that my lips are done and my face is done, I like to go in and do my bottom mascara. I always save it for like the last thing or one of the last things, because I'm so worried I'm gonna like, it's gonna be wet and I'm gonna hit it with my beauty blender and get it all over my face. Alright, so now the last thing to do is use my Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. Alright my lovelies, this is the final look. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button below, and if you're new, please subscribe to my channel. I post new videos every single Monday. As always, the links for all the products used in today's video will be in the description box below, as well as the links for my other social media sites so you can keep up with me during the week. Leave me a comment below and let me know what you want to see in my next video, and I will see you guys next week.